Hey kids, it's Larsen Halleck, the internet's best kept secret and nowhere near the internet's favorite fitness and men's interest writer and vlogger. I am back with videos after a brief hiatus. Allow me to briefly explain. I used to do movie and video game reviews, both of which are media that I am into, and I wanted to give my opinions on them, as many others have done, but from a, shall we say, uncucked perspective. That didn't go so hot, I feel, for a couple of reasons. The first and biggest being that, as much fun as I had doing it, and for the praise I got from the approximately 3 people that regularly watch those videos, it wasn't really relevant to my website's mission, and it wasn't doing anything for the masculine self-improvement that I dedicate most of my internet time to. The second is that, like the clod I am, I completely failed to notice that the whole wacky internet reviewer guy thing is, for the most part, not as popular as it used to be. I was never really into it. But of the ones I do like, Razorfist now intersperses current events with his reviews, and Spoonie has apparently lost his goddamn mind, and spends his day drinking himself into a stupor and making an ass of himself on Twitter. But I digress. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, pick up assholes. What is it, you may ask yourself? It is literally the same thing I do with the Fail Order Catalogue, except instead of criticizing bad martial arts and fitness, I criticize bad game, pickup artistry, and all the myriad types of attempted pelvic sorcery. But before I go into this, a little bit of backstory. I was a kissless virgin up until my sophomore year in college, and I was mentally girding myself for a life of involuntary celibacy pretty much up until that time. So imagine, if you will, me, an awkward and sexually frustrated high school boy who was trying and failing miserably to get my hands on some nubile teenage flesh pots, and then all of a sudden, like manna from God, the mystery method comes out. So me and a couple of my Dungeons & Dragons buddies...
Larsen was an avid Dungeons & Dragons player as a teenager, and can very occasionally be convinced to roll the dice should his high school friends drop by for a visit. Should you feel the need to mock this, please visit the martial arts tutorial playlist and imagine your face replacing the punching bag.
Passed the book around and decided that we could use this to get girls. And so we outfitted ourselves with big poofy hats and ruffly shirts and beaver head cod pieces, looking for all the world like homosexual Ren Faire rent boys, as we aimed to utilize what mystery had taught us to bring us into a maelstrom of muff. And somehow we managed to get even less action than we were already getting. Long story short, I fucked up a lot in my quest, but I eventually figured out through the School of Hard Knocks that the key to getting women is to make yourself a man worth having and develop a healthy and natural confidence, combined with some rudimentary public speaking and masculine body language development. Incidentally, that's essentially the conclusion that the good people at Return of Kings came to independently and proceeded to proselytize a good 3 years before I made my first website. Oh, I sure am a Johnny-come-lately, aren't I? The point is, I've been burned by bad pickup artistry, as well as bad fitness trainers, so I want to keep young men from falling into the same traps that I did, and profile individual bad PUA material, as well as tips on how to identify it. And so finally I get to the point. Let's look at Joshua Pellicer's idiotic IP, the Tao of Badass, aka Be a Real Badass, aka the one, the only, Obtuse Seduction Flowcharts. Who is Mr. Pellicer, you might ask yourself? Well, according to this website that advertises the Tao of Badass in its main navigation bar, Megan X, who you know is a woman because she loudly announces it, feels that Joshua has truly cracked the dating code for the common man. Looking at Mr. Pellicer's website, we see him offering a $67 Tao of Badass course. Expensive? Yes. But it's a $2,400 value, you see. I managed to get this book through totally legal means, and looking through it, some of it's sensible. I mean, he discusses gender roles and how men and women evolve to be certain ways. Women don't always want to be dominant in a relationship, but that's hardly anything new. He also discusses confidence, and this is where the book goes completely off the goddamn track. He discusses value levels and neural feedback and AMOGs and stages of belief creation, all in all representing the talking like a retard part of the manosphere that one of my esteemed ROK colleagues made fun of many years ago. You know what's missing from this list? The actually effective means of becoming confident, which is to say, doing shit, having accomplishments under your belt, and gaining confidence through that. I've discussed this many times on my website, and being somebody who did suffer from social anxiety and lack of confidence as a child, I think I would know. All the fruity self-affirmations and forced body language are good, but they're kind of like building a house on the sand. The human character is the foundation. And if that human spends all his time jerking off and playing Call of Duty, he's going to find out real goddamn quick he has nothing to be confident about. And if that sounds familiar, that's because it's a lot like yours truly in high school. But wait, there's more. His ebook came with the multi-orgasmic lover as well. Because this guy seems like he just has a train of ladies coming to his bedchambers. And this guy does too. And much like the Tao, it seems like a few grains of good advice covered in mounds of horse shit. Stop masturbating, do Kegels, and freeze. That's literally all you need. Trust me. But no, let Studley Joshua and Jimbo the Magnificent here tell you, intently focus on your genitals while saying swear words. Do the horse dance and activate your fuck energy.
What the hell is that?
And now the moment we've all been waiting for. The one, the only, obtuse seduction flowcharts! Because I hate myself, let's walk through the play-by-play attraction guide, which he says is a la flowchart. I believe the word he meant to say was via flowchart. Step 1. Find the girl who's attractive. Okay. If she smiles or approaches you, turn your chest and head, but don't lean in. If she does not smile, turn your head, but not your chest, and do not lean in. Step 2. Does she turn to face you with her body? If not, turn away from her for exactly 1 second, and then turn back and continue the playful banter. If she does face you, proceed to the playful banter. Use playful banter. Banter which, if I didn't know better, I'd say was negging. I am a bit ambivalent on the subject, as some of you may know. If the negging fails, and it will, repeat at least 3 times before giving up and moving on. She's smiling and laughing. Turn your back to her, look. Jesus, we're supposed to remember all this? Can you imagine somebody actually doing this? Like, can you imagine some pencil neck dweeb pulling at his shirt collar trying to remember if he's supposed to turn away for exactly 4 seconds or 5 seconds? Oh, by the way, guess what you're supposed to do when your spastic body rhythm fails to turn her on? Use playful banter. Because I'm sure that'll work. Yeah, if you ever find yourself in a situation, any situation, and the first conclusion you jump to is more negging, rethink your life choices. Oh look, here's a non-copyright infringing image of Bruce Lee to remind us that this is supposed to be the Tao, like the Tao of Jeet Kune Do. Because when I think Tao, I think of a rigidly structured flowchart. The Tao that can be spoken of is not the true Tao. Truth is never eloquent, and eloquence is never truth. 6-hour-long instructional video. Yeah, it's basically the same thing. When she gives you her hand, twirl her around like a ballerina. Well, I suppose that might work if you're in a club dancing. Otherwise, I think Joshua Pellicer has confused a woman with little girl. Out of curiosity, what is the legal status of the Tao of Badass vis-a-vis elementary schools? Flowcharts, Venn diagrams, and the stage of attraction ends. But wait, you still have to do the stage of rapport. This is a rigidly organized chain of dialogue for having a conversation with a woman, which I think explains more than anything else what sort of person would be interested in this. And mercifully, it ends. So that was a brief overview of Joshua Pellicer's The Tao of Badass. Like a heap of slag with a few gleanable bits of coal in it, this Tao has a few common sense good ideas buried under a mound of idiocy. I was kinda hoping that men had collectively moved away from the rigidity of the dumbass turn-of-the-millennium PUA stuff, but that's apparently not the case. I'm Larsen Halleck for TheBarbaricGentleman.com and all those other websites that I write for, coming back with more videos on a semi-regular basis. Mr. Joshua Pellicer will be coming back soon with guides on how to convince a woman to marry you, and how to be a strong and dynamic patriarch to your wife and children, both in the form of even bigger and better flowcharts. And considering that this first one was 7 megabytes, you better prepare your anus.